All right, Briohny here from Accelerate Off-Grid Touring. We have just completed an epic off-grid upgrade to this Jayco motorhome. It's an Optimum. So come and take a look with us. 400 amp hours of lithium inverter, all the charging to keep you off-grid as long as the sun is shining. All right, now we're going to run you through each component that we've put into this Jayco motorhome. So let's start with the big blue boxes right at the front. They are Invicta lithium batteries. We've got two 200 amp hour batteries in here. So that's giving you 400 amp hours of lithium. The reason we like upgrading you to lithium from AGM batteries, they're lightweight. You've got a longer usable lifespan out of them. The 200 amp hour capacity is more usable. You get more out of that 200 hours than you would in a 200 hour AGM. There's so many positives to lithium. The reason we go Invicta is they've got a 7-year full replacement warranty. They have IEC certification, which is certification or mandatory certification that was introduced a year or two ago on lithium batteries in inhabitable spaces. So Invicta have got the certification on each cell and also on the battery as a complete. So they're one of the only ones out there that have that, but they were actually one of the first ones to ever have that and before any of the mandatory standards came in. So we absolutely love Invicta. Use them in the majority of our systems now. You've also got a Bluetooth app that you can connect through to. You can see the batteries individually or as a bank, and you can see the status going into the batteries, the status going out of the batteries, the percentage of the batteries. We can use it to, you know, troubleshoot sort of thing while you're on the road if you ever have problems with them. So yeah, Invicta lithium batteries are our choice in our off-grid setups these days. All right, the next things we've then got is all the ways you're going to charge your lithium batteries. So we're going to start off with charging your batteries from your alternator in your vehicle while you are driving. So we use the Enerdrive 40 amp DC to DC charger in this particular system. So basically what that does is it gives you 40 amps of charge per hour into the battery. So if you've got a 400 amp hour system from completely flat, which they hopefully will never be, you're going to take approximately 10 hours to charge them up. That also does have a solar input in there, which we quite often wire to have an external panel. So you can plug an external panel in when you're stationary, and that will go via the DC to DC charger. The reason we keep that separate is it's a different size panel to what's on the roof typically, and we don't see as good efficiency if we're running two different size panels through the one charger. So we like to have the external solar option through the DC to DC charger. Next up, we have got the Victron MPPT 100 over 50 solar controller. We don't go green on solar controllers anymore. That's just a personal preference. Us, when we were traveling, we just liked the Victron ones. We found we got a better input on them than what we did on some of the other brands there. And we did actually test multiple ones in there. So what that solar controller on this particular build has got going into it is 490 watt Enerdrive panels, all going into that solar controller. Now that will allow you, while you've got the solar controller and the DC to DC charger, when you're driving, you're going to get input from both. So you're going to get input via the DC to DC charger from the alternator and then via your solar panels from the solar controller. So we're really trying to get maximum or optimum or high input into those batteries on those travel days when you're moving campsites, and that's quite often when you're really depleted because you've done all the washing and that sort of thing. So yeah, separate solar controller and loving the Victron ones at the moment in these builds. Next up, we're going to go to the AC charger. So that's the third way you can charge your batteries, is via an AC charger. So in this build, we've done a 60 amp hour Enerdrive battery charger. So what that is doing is if for whatever reason you're at a caravan park or you're back at home and you need to charge your batteries up, plug it in to external power source or 240 volt or mains power, whatever you want to call it, and that's going to put 60 amps of charge into your batteries when you're plugged in. So that one's nice and simple. When you're off grid, you don't really need to know about it at all. Next up, we've got the Enerdrive 2600 watt inverter, and that is the device that I absolutely love when you're camping. It's what gives you your creature comforts from home. It takes it from just a camping experience to a glamping experience in my opinion. So the inverter is what converts the 12 volt power that is stored in your batteries into 240 volt power that allows you to power all your household devices. In this instance, it's going to run the AC, your rooftop AC system. It can run toasters, kettles, hair straighteners, coffee machines, air fryers, I don't know, whatever you want to run that's a household appliance. That is going to run off the inverter, and I think they are, for off-grid camping, your real must-have. So the transferred side of the inverter is basically, so when it's wired and you're running off your batteries and you plug into mains, it's a seamless integration. So you're not going to have any dropouts of your AC system or whatever appliances are running. Everything's just going to keep running. And same thing when you unplug that power cord. If you've got a load of washing on, you're leaving a caravan park, you unplug the power cord, your washing machine is going to keep going. There's no disruptions to that cycle. All right, we're inside here in the camper van now. Motorhome. So up here we have got the existing BMPro JHub screen. We haven't touched that. It stays the same. It does all the switching, so your lights in your caravan or your water tank monitoring. We have added in the inverter on off, so we can turn the inverter on from within here. And we've also got the Enerdrive ePRO in here as well. So that is a backup to your apps. It's monitoring what's going in, what's going out of your batteries, the percentage status and that sort of thing. I've not seen this before. I don't know if it's to Jayco motorhomes that do this, but it has got an onboard generator. So if for whatever reason you are off grid and you need more power, you can basically turn on your generator and that will automatically go through the Enerdrive AC charger we've installed and start charging your batteries for you automatically without having to plug anything in or cables running everywhere. So that's quite a nifty thing. I question why you need a generator when you have our lithium system, because usually you don't have to travel with one. And the motorhomes have a curved roof, so we typically can't get as much solar on there. So this has got 490 watt panels on the roof. Sometimes we get that, or we get six of them plus some other smaller panels on there. With the curvature of the roof in the motorhome and some additional hatches in here, that was the maximum we could get up. The customer was okay with that because they have a generator on board as well. So something nice and nifty for this Jayco. All right, as always, guys, thank you so much for watching. If you do have any questions or comments, please leave them below. If you would like to get one of our systems, fill out the contact form on our website. Next up, YouTube really thinks you should watch this video here. And if you want to see any more of our off-grid setups in caravans or motorhomes, watch these videos down here.
Accelerate off-grid touring, powering your adventures.